We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted but not forsaken, struck down but not destroyed, always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So then death is working in us, but life in you. And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believed and therefore I spoke, we also believe and therefore speak, knowing that he who raised up the Lord Jesus will also raise us up with Jesus, and will present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, that grace, having spread through the many, may cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of God. 2 Corinthians 4:8-15. Glory to you, Holy One. Blessed be the name of our Father God, the great I am that I am. Hallowed are the words of life and freedom for your family of faith. Oh, how I need these words this morning, the reminder of truth that can set our heart and minds at ease as rest. Please touch my spirit this morning afresh and anew with your word of life to me. I come in Jesus' blessed name, amen. Lord, to walk the walk of faith, to believe in you, is not an easy walk in the park. Yes, the righteous must walk by faith and not by sight, or by our feelings. We must believe in what we do not see more than what we see and feel in this body of flesh. For we do go through these things written above here. I have, and am going through these. I have been pressed on every side, but I am not crushed. I do get perplexed and when will it ease up? But I have not fallen into despair. My little persecutions are nothing at all, and I know you have never forsaken me even when I deserve to be forsaken by my actions and attitudes. And I do feel like Satan is trying to strike me down, but I am far from being destroyed. For the life that I am living for and to you and not to him or anyone else but you and your glory. Lord, for the longest till this morning I read these verses but did not pay close attention to the fact that we carry about in this flesh, Lord Jesus, your death, in our dying out to ourselves and our daily flesh desires. We are learning to crucify this body, this life we live and die out to it that we may live in and by your spirit in us and not our carnal natures anymore. So yes, I am letting go of the flesh daily to live for the glory of you, Lord God, and not my own will and wants. Not living so much anymore to please myself but more and more to please the one who gave his all for me. Father, you have been so good to me, so patient and kind daily. It is very true that these momentary afflictions are not worthy to be compared to the glory that you have prepared for your children in heaven. This life here is but one single grain of sand in all the oceans of time in eternity. Yet most live like it is all we will ever have when it is so far from it. Lord, it is true if we live only for our own gratification we are miserable creatures, for we will never be filled. We may have what we think we want for a very brief moment, but soon that moment passes and so does that momentary pleasure. It is not sustainable. Only you, in you, and by you, can we have the blessed peace and rest for our souls in the knowledge that this too will all end and glory and paradise awaits your children. No more tears, no more suffering in this body that is perishing. We cannot keep it. Why do we want to keep what is falling apart and not want a glorious body that will not get sick, old or ever die? I will one day never get tired, or have a cold, or ache in my bones. I will not get age spots and droop and sag and feel achy. I have tasted and seen that you are better than all this life has that is quickly fading away. I have chosen the better way, praise you my Lord Jesus and Father. Father, thank you that one day I will see you. Thank you that you gave your Son for me. Thank you for loving me even when I did not love you, or want you. For loving me and protecting me till I came to you. Thank you for sustaining me now and being so good to me. Thank you for shielding me from evil, many things I never see that are aimed at me that never touch me. Thank you for your blessing us with no lack. We are well fed, sleep well, have a nice roof over our heads, health to do our work, and many who love us too. I am blessed so well. But the best of all is you. Your love and faithfulness to me and mine. Thank you so. I close this time with you, in the holy name of the Lord Jesus Christ, my Lord. My Savior. Amen.